Hello my friends, it's Kayla, and I'm back again with my favorite video ever to film upcoming releases, newly announced books, what's another title, reading Goodreads synopses to you for 30 minutes straight. I realized I haven't done one of these since February, and I miss it. I just want to talk about all of the things that I've recently added to my Goodreads shelf to read or on my radar, just things that I see around the internet that I think I might read one day. And then I just tell them to you and you listen. And maybe you add them to your Goodreads. I don't know, your life. Okay, first, I normally start out with things that have gotten cover reveals. So these are books that I've already talked about probably in upcoming releases, things that have been announced. And then once they get a cover, I talk about them again. So let me get out of the way so I can show you the beauty. Blackout got a cover reveal. This is all of the authors. It's like set in New York during a blackout. I don't know, should I read you the synopsis again? I already have. Let's do it again. A summer heatwave blankets New York City in darkness, but as the city is thrown into confusion, a different kind of electricity sparks. A first meeting, longtime friends, bitter exes, and maybe the beginning of something new. When the lights go out, people reveal hidden truths. Love blossoms, friendship forms, and new possibilities take flight. I have read from every single one of these authors. I love short story collections. I especially love short story collections that have something that's tying them together, and I could not be more excited about this. I think it already comes out like this month, but the cover reveal didn't happen until just a couple months ago. Okay, the next one is called Ophelia After All. It's by Raquel Marie, and this is one of my favorite covers I've like ever seen. I think it's beautiful. The illustration style, the colors, the font, like I'm so in love. And now I can't remember if I've actually read this all to you. Ophelia Rojas knows what she likes: her best friend, Cuban food, rose gardening, and boys. Way too many boys. Her friends and parents make fun of her endless stream of crushes, but Ophelia is a romantic at heart. She couldn't change even if she wanted to. So when she finds herself thinking more about cute, quiet Talia Sanchez than the loss of a perfect prom with her ex-boyfriend, seeds of doubt take root in Ophelia's firm image of herself. Add to that the impending end of high school and the fracturing of her once solid friend group, and things are spiraling a little out of control. But the course of love and sexuality never did run smooth. As her secrets begin to unravel, Ophelia must make a choice between clinging to the fantasy version of herself she's always imagined, or upending everyone's expectations to rediscover who she really is after all. This comes out in 2022. It's one of my most anticipated of the year. I have followed Rocky on Twitter and then YouTube for a while, so it's gonna be great. Another cover reveal were for Where the Drowned Girls Go by Sean McGuire, which is the next book in the Wayward Children series. I do think I've read this synopsis before. It's book number 7, and we're at a different school. The publisher has like talked about how this is a standalone, but Sean McGuire has been like, no, it's not. You need to read them in order to fully still like get the story. But at this one, we're at Whitethorn Institute. It says, when Eleanor West decided to open her home, her sanctuary, her home for wayward children, she knew from the beginning that there would be children she couldn't save. When Cora decides she needs a different direction, a different fate, a different prophecy, Miss West reluctantly agrees to transfer her to the other school where things are run very differently by Whitethorn, the headmaster. This one comes out in January, like they all do, and I think it sounds wonderful. The cover is right up my alley. I know all the covers are so similar. My mom's actually borrowing them all right now and reading through them, and I hope she loves them. But this one especially, like, it's got water, it's got the night sky, oh my gosh, my favorite cover reveal is A Snake Falls to Earth by Darcy Little Badger. I feel like I've talked about this book a couple times, but the cover reveal happened and completely exceeded my expectations, and it comes out in just a couple months. This is actually one of my favorite covers I've ever seen. Like, the art style, the colors, I'm obsessed. It follows a girl named Nina. Nina is a little pan girl in our world. She's always felt there was something more out there. She still believes in the old stories. Ollie is a cottonmouth kid from the land of spirits and monsters. Like all cottonmouths, he's been cast from home. He's found a new one on the banks of the bottomless lake. Nina and Ollie have no idea the other exists, but a catastrophic event on earth and a strange sickness that befalls Ollie's best friend will drive their worlds together in ways they haven't been in centuries, and there will be some who will kill to keep them apart. I absolutely cannot wait to read it. And then the next Nina LaCour, I think I talked about before, but maybe I haven't. But it got a cover reveal. It's definitely different looking from all of her other books. It's called Yerba Buena, and I think it's an adult title. Sarah is a broken girl from a drug-soaked Northern California town. Fueled by panic, desperation, and impulse, she heads south hoping to start over in LA. A decade after Sarah has come into the restaurant industry, we meet Emily, the granddaughter of Creoles who left New Orleans to escape segregation. Emily takes a job arranging flowers for an elegant LA restaurant. Sorry, the description is not coded correctly, so there's like weird spacing. And things get complicated when she captures the attention of the restaurateur and engages in an affair. When Sarah and Emily meet, their connection is immediate. But before they can find a way forward, both Sarah and Emily must reckon with the places they came from, even if it means revisiting what they'd rather leave behind. Okay, and then a book I've talked about a couple times because I'm so excited to read anything else from Echo Brown after Black Girl Unlimited, The Chosen One finally got a cover reveal. This is a January release and it's beautiful. I haven't even read the synopsis of this one myself, so we're gonna do it together. There are many watchers and they're always white. That's the first thing Echo notices as she settles into Dartmouth College. Despite graduating high school in Cleveland as valedictorian, Echo immediately struggles to keep up in demanding classes. Dartmouth made many promises it couldn't keep. The campus is not rainbow-colored utopia where education lifts every voice, nor is it a paradise of ideas, an incubator of inclusivity, or even an exciting dating scene. But it might be a portal to different dimensions of time and space, only accessible if Echo accepts her calling as a chosen one and takes charge of her future by healing her past. This remarkable challenge demands vulnerability, humility, and the conviction to ask for help without sacrificing self-worth. This doesn't sound like a sequel, but we are interestingly still following a character inspired by the author herself. So interesting. I'm reading it regardless of what it is. Oh my gosh, and then The Mercury Boys, one of my most anticipated reads of the year, also got a cover reveal and I love it. This is by Chandra Prasad and it has that like underwater, slightly submerged vibe that I've talked about that I love so much. This one comes out very soon too, in August. And it says, after her life is upended by a divorce and a cross-country move, 16-year-old Saskia Brown feels like an outsider at her new school. Not only is she a transplant, she's biracial in a population of mostly white students. One day while visiting her friend at her part-time library job, Saskia encounters a vial of liquid mercury, then touches an old daguerreotype, the precursor of the modern day photograph, and makes a startling discovery. She's somehow able to visit the man in the portrait, a brilliant young inventor from the 19th century. The hitch, she can only see him in her dreams. And then she like brings in a bunch of other girls and they all like have this boy that they bring or that they visit in their dreams, and it just sounds like so much fun. Next is White Smoke by Tiffany D. Jackson. This is really different than I was expecting for a cover because a lot of her covers have the same kind of vibe. And this one looks very intense and haunted. It says it's a mix of The Haunting of Hill House and Get Out. Marigold is running from ghosts. The phantoms of her old life keep haunting her, but a move with her newly blended family from their small California beach town to the embattled Midwestern city of Cedarville might be the fresh start she needs. Her mom has accepted a new job with the Sterling Foundation that comes with a free house, one that Mary now has to share with her bratty 10-year-old stepsister, Piper. The renovated picture-perfect home on Maple Street sitting between dilapidated houses surrounded by wary neighbors has its ... secrets. That's only half the problem. Household items vanish, doors open on their own, lights turn off, shadows walk past rooms, voices can be heard in the walls, and there's a foul smell seeping through the vents only Mary seems to notice. I think this is going to be one of those fun ones that you don't really know if it's paranormal or realistic fiction, since Tiffany D. Jackson, I've read most of her books and they are all realistic. So I wonder if it's all like more of a metaphor or if it actually will go like fully there. Either way, I'm in. Okay, and then some recently announced ones that don't have covers, so I'll just pop up like the announcement or if it has like a fake cover or whatever. All My Rage by Saba Tahir. I feel like a lot of you might be interested in. This is a contemporary, which is cool. And there's also a couple different timelines. So we're following one character, Misbah, in Pakistan, then, it says. And then we're following a character named Salahuddin and Noor in California now, so current day. So then it says, Miss Bell is a dreamer and storyteller, newly married in an arranged match. After their young life is shaken by tragedy, they come to the United States. And in the now timeline, we have best friends, basically family, growing up as outcasts in the small desert town of Juniper, California. They understand each other the way no one else does, until the fight, which destroys their bond with a swift fury of a star exploding. Now, Sal scrambles to run the family motel as his mother, Mispa's health fails, and his grieving father loses himself to alcoholism. Noor, meanwhile, walks a harrowing tightrope, working at her wrathful uncle's liquor store while hiding the fact that she's applying to college so she can escape him and Juniper forever. And that comes out in early 2022. Next up today, Thompson has a newly announced book called Far From the Light of Heaven. I don't know if I like this cover, but it is science fiction. I read The Murders of Molly Southbourne last year and really liked it. This is like a full space kind of story, which sounds exciting. The colony ship Ragtime docks in the Lagos system, having traveled light years from home to bring thousands of sleeping souls to safety among the stars. Some of the sleepers, however, will never wake, and a profound and sinister mystery unfolds aboard the gigantic vessel as its skeleton crew makes decisions that will have repercussions for the entire system. From the scheming politicians of Lagos Station to the colony of Nightshade and the poisoned planet of Bloodroot, poised for a civil war. That's a little vague for me, but I'm gonna read it. Next up, we got a title for the next Sherry Demoline book, which I'm very excited about because it is the sequel to The Marrow Thieves. I never thought The Marrow Thieves would get a sequel, but I'm very intrigued. It's called Hunting by Stars, and it says, years ago when plagues and natural disasters killed millions of people, much of the world stopped dreaming. If you haven't read the first book, I don't want to give too much away. Without dreams, people are haunted, sick, mad, unable to rebuild. The government soon finds that indigenous people of North America have retained their dreams, an ability rumored to be housed in the very marrow of their bones. We already know all that. Soon, residential schools pop up or are reopened across the land to bring in the dreamers and harvest their dreams. 17-year-old French lost his family to these schools and has spent the years since headed north with his newfound family, a group of other dreamers who, like him, are trying to build and thrive as a community. But then French wakes up in a pitch black room, locked in and alone for the first time in years, and he knows immediately where he is and what it will take to escape. This one comes out, it says October 2021, but it doesn't have a cover, so I'm not sure if that's an accurate date, but whenever it comes out, I will be reading it. Next up, I saw The Vacation by John Mars come through my updates on Goodreads, and I had no idea he had an upcoming book. The date on here says June 2021, but when I checked like Book Depository, it said 2022. And once again, it's from a big group of people, all different POVs. There are 8 of them. And it says, how far will you run to escape your past? Venice Beach, Los Angeles, a paradise on earth. Tourists flock to the Golden Coast and the promise of Hollywood. But for 8 strangers at a beachfront hostel, there is far more on their mind than an extended vacation. All of them are running from something, and they all have secrets they'd kill to keep. That's all there is, and I'm absolutely gonna read it. Okay, next up is from Kate Alice Marshall. It's a book called These Fleeting Shadows. Oh, there's no description. That's it. That's all I have. I recently read my first Kate Alice Marshall, but for some reason I own like every single one of her books. I just feel like she's an author for me. I've read one and really enjoyed it, so I just automatically add this one to my TBR. Maybe you want to as well, knowing nothing about it. Next up, I added the new Megan Giddings, which also has no description, but I read Lakewood last year and enjoyed it. So this one's called The Women Could Fly, and that's all we know about it. Also, this one has no real information. It's called Extasia by Claire Legrand, author of Sawkill Girls, which I really, really liked. No description. Automatically added it though. Next up, Hannah Alcaff has an upcoming book. She wrote The Weight of Our Sky, that's over there. This one is called Queen of the Tiles. And it says, when cryptic messages begin appearing on a dead girl's social media account during an international Scrabble championship in Malaysia, a girl must investigate the mysterious circumstances of her best friend's death and uncover the truth before a would-be killer strikes again. I never knew that I needed a book about Scrabble, but I love Scrabble so much that like, I can't believe I've never read a book around Scrabble. And also it's a mystery. Like, doesn't that sound so fun? Okay, another thriller that pulled me in, because anything with a game, you know, you just know. It's called These Deadly Games by Diana Urban. And there's a time limit on it, which also gets me. It says, you have 24 hours to win or lose your life. I've read many books about games and not many of them have been incredible, but I'm always ready to pick up another one. So it says, let's play a game. You have 24 hours to win. If you break my rules, she dies. If you call the police, she dies. If you tell your parents or anyone else, she dies. When Crystal Donovan gets a message on a mysterious app with a video of her little sister gagged and bound, she agrees to play the kidnapper's game. At first, they make her complete bizarre tasks. Steal a test and stuff it in a locker, bake brownies, make prank calls. But then Crystal realizes each task is meant to hurt and kill her friends one by one. But if she refuses to play, the kidnapper will kill her sister. Is someone trying to take her team out of the running for a gaming tournament? Or have they uncovered a secret from their past that wants them to pay for what they did? I have another couple anthologies on my list. This one is called Adoptee to Adoptee. It's edited by Shannon Gibney and Nicole Chung. And it says it's a YA anthology featuring new stories by adoptee authors with contributions from a whole bunch of authors that I'll list. I have only read from two of them. So that'll be a fun introduction to some new authors, which is what I love anthologies for. The other one on my list is called Cool Awkward Black, an anthology that explores the joys and multitudes within Black geekhood from a number of Black authors, edited by Karen Strong. This has a couple authors I read from before, Toshio Noguchi and Amory. And then again, a whole bunch of new people I've never read from before. Both of those are set for 2023. And then I feel like I've talked about this somewhere, but maybe it was just that I retweeted it, and it's that Nevo officially has three more books in the Singing Hills cycle coming out, and we got a title for the third book. This is like one of my favorite series of all time, The Empress of Soul and Fortune, and then When the Tiger Came Down the Mountain. And book number three is called Into the Riverlands. We're still following a cleric named Chi, and in this book it says they fall in with a pair of young women far from home and an older couple who are more than they seem. As Chi runs headlong into an ancient feud, they find themselves far more entangled in the history of the Riverlands than they ever expected to be. Honestly, I can't wait for the cover reveal for that. Like, these covers are so stunning that I just want to see what it's going to look like. Then I added this one called Nettle and Bone by T. Kingfisher, who wrote The Hollow Places that I read last year. I don't think I've read the synopsis, I just automatically added it, so let's find out. It says, after years of seeing her sister suffer at the hands of an abusive prince, Mara, the shy, convent-raised, third-born daughter, has finally realized that no one is coming to their rescue. No one except Mara herself. Seeking help from a powerful grave witch, Mara is offered the tools to kill a prince. If she can complete three impossible tasks, I love that! But as is the way in tales of princesses, witches, and daughters, the impossible is only the beginning. On her quest, Mara is joined by the Grave Witch, a reluctant fairy godmother, a strapping former knight, and a chicken possessed by a demon. Together, the five of them intend to be the hand that closes around the throat of the prince and frees Mara's family and their kingdom from its tyrannous ruler at last. This is only like 250 pages, but it comes out in about a year. And then this one I just searched on Goodreads and it has a cover. I didn't think it did because I just saw the announcement on Twitter. It's by Layla Sabrine and it's called You Truly Assumed. And it says, Sabria has her whole summer planned out in color-coded glory. But those plans go out the window after a terrorist attack near her home. When the terrorist is assumed to be Muslim and Islamophobia grows, Sabria turns to her online journal for comfort. You Truly Assumed was never meant to be anything more than an outlet, but the blog goes viral as fellow Muslim teens around the country flock to it and find solace and a sense of community. Soon, two more teens, Zakat and Farah, join Bree to run You Truly Assumed, and the three quickly form a strong friendship. But as the blog's popularity grows, so do the pushback and hateful comments. But one of them is threatening, and the search to find out who is behind it all begins, and their friendship is put to the test when all three must decide whether to shut down the blog and lose what they've worked for, or take a stand and risk everything to make their voices heard. This one just says 2022 as the release, and I think I heard about it from Deepa Jagadar, who absolutely loved it. Speaking of Adiba, there is a listing on Goodreads called A Million to One without a description. So you know I'm adding that right now. There's also a listing for a new Taryn Fisher that doesn't have a description, but it's called An Honest Lie. And it says it's a heart-stopping thriller with an epic twist, available March 2022. And of course, me adding every single book with the word lie in the title to my TBR. I have another one from A.R. Tor, who's the author of The Girl in 6E. This one's called The Good Lie, and it says, 6 teens murdered, a suspect behind bars, a desperate father. In a case this shadowy, the truth is easy to hide. Following a psychiatrist who's an expert on killers, she spent a decade treating California's most depraved predators and unlocking their motives. Then we have another main character, defense attorney Robert, is a still traumatized father whose own son fell prey to the bloody heart killer. He steps in to represent somebody who's being accused. And then Gwen and Robert grow closer and she dives deeper into the investigation and becomes suspicious that Robert is hiding something. This one apparently comes out like next month, but I only just heard about it. Okay, as usual, between filming and posting this video every single time, there's inevitably something that gets announced and that I feel like I have to include. So I just saw Emily XR Pan have something pop up. I have had this book like listing on my Goodreads for years. I love The Astonishing Color of After so much, so I'm excited to read anything else she puts out. I haven't read this yet, I just saw the cover, and the cover is lovely. So let's find out what it's about. Oh my god, it starts out saying Romeo and Juliet, so you know I'm in. If I wasn't already in, I'm so in. Romeo and Juliet meets Chinese mythology in this magical novel, blah, blah, blah. In Fairbridge, a series of bizarre phenomena brings together a pair of star-crossed lovers from rival families. Hunter Yi has perfect aim with a bow and arrow, but all else in his life veers wrong. He's sick of being haunted by his family's past mistakes. The only thing keeping him from running away are his little brother, a supernatural wind, and the bewitching girl at his new school. Luna Chang dreads the future. It's the last year of high school and her parents' expectations are stifling. When she begins to write the rules, she finds her life upended. Is it just me or was that word used a lot in this video? Upended by the strange new boy in her class, the arrival of unearthly fireflies, and an ominous crack spreading across town. As Hunter and Luna navigate their family's enmity and secrets, everything around them begins to fall apart. All they can depend on is their love. But time is running out and fate will have its way. There's no page count, but I anticipate this being another long one and I'm excited. It's supposed to come out in April. I'll be reading it. What about you? Let me scroll through all of the books on my TBR by like publication date just to make sure nothing else I miss, like no other covers have popped up since filming this. Still waiting for information on The Fall Boys and Dizzy in Paradise, Jandy Nelson. I actually attended a Zoom with her a couple months ago where she gave us an insight into that book. So like it's still happening. I think the title is a little bit different, but whatever, I can't wait. Okay, it doesn't look like I missed anything else. So let me know what you learned about. Let me know if you're excited about any of these picks. Of all of these, tell me the thing that sounds most intriguing or looks most intriguing to you. And thanks for hanging out with me. I'll see you soon. Bye.